everybody, welcome back to my channel. So today I want to talk about something that's a little bit controversial on the Instagram lately, and this is called color correction. And if you don't know what color correction is, it's that thing on Instagram when those girls do the 15 second makeup videos. It's where they have red underneath their eyes or green dots all over their face before they put on their foundation and their concealer. This is called color correction. So I wanted to kind of talk about my perspective on color correction and what I think is the right way and the way that you should do it. I mean, there is no correct way of doing makeup. You can do makeup however you want to, but I do have my own beliefs about makeup and I want to share them with you. So color correction starts with something very simple that we learned in kindergarten, the color wheel. I went ahead and printed out a color wheel for you guys to show you and kind of give you an example of what color correction is all about. So I went to beauty school. If you haven't been following me for a while, I went to beauty school a while ago and I learned everything about color correction, everything to do with color, because color is very important to learn about when you're doing someone's hair. So I just wanted to show you kind of the basics of color correction. So basically, if you don't know the purpose of color correction, it is to take either a warm color or a cool color and make it neutral. So this bottom half are the cool colors and the top half are the warm colors. So for example, if you have like a zit on your face, like right here, the zit is most likely red. So you want to take the opposite color of red and put that over the red, blend it in so it becomes neutral. So the opposite of red is green. So I would put green on any red blemishes that I have around my face and neutralize those and then put foundation over. And then when we're talking about dark circles, usually dark circles are bluish, purplish, sometimes can be greenish. So this is like in this area. So you want to cover up your dark circles with either an orangey or a red color or a lighter orange or even like a salmon color. You can cover up your dark circles. You have to kind of play around with these colors with color correction to see what works best for you. I've realized that when I color correct on my own face, when I'm covering up my dark circles, I realize that an orange works better than a red for me, just because red is a little too intense. And then also when people are color correcting, some people like to focus on the darkness around their mouth. Some people have a lot of darkness like in their upper lip or on the sides of their mouth. You would cover that up with like a light lavender color or just a light concealer. I only ever color correct when my skin is acting up a lot and I have an event to go to and I have to look really good where I'm taking pictures. That's when I'll color correct my own face. So enough of me babbling. I hope that all made sense. And let's go ahead and get started. So first thing you want to do is prime. So what I'm going to do is use the Baby Skin by Maybelline. So the first thing that I'm going to focus on are my dark circles. I don't know if you guys can see them very well because my lights might be drowning them out, but my dark circles are more bluish and purplish than anything. Opposite of purple and blue is more of an orangey color. I'm going to be using the LA Girl Pro concealers, and this one is just their orange color. And to make sure that I don't get like an excess amount of product on my face, I'm going to squeeze a little bit on the back of my hand. I'm going to take my ring finger, not flipping you off, take a little tiny bit, because this stuff is super pigmented, and just focus it right on the darker parts. So now I'm going to focus on the red spots around my face. So opposite of red is green. So I'm going to take the green LA Girl Pro Concealer, do the same thing, put it on the back of my hand, and use my fingers to blend everything in. You want to really make sure that you push the product into your skin. You don't want to have any excess product hanging out on the top of your skin, because that way it'll seep into the concealer that you put on top of it. And you can kind of see that the green, like obviously it still looks green, but it automatically takes away that redness. I look really cute, right? right now. Okay, so what I'm going to do with the lighter concealer, I don't have like a light lavender concealer. Sometimes people use that color to disguise darker areas on the face. So I have really deep smile lines because my smile is super big. The struggle, as you can see when I smile, they just like are super deep. They tend to kind of like pop out when I'm not wearing makeup or anything over them. So I'm gonna take a little bit of light concealer and just go over those areas to kind of disguise the darkness. Now that we look really cute, I like to take a little bit of translucent setting powder. So I'm going to use the Sonia Kashuk Brightening Powder and kind of just go over the areas that I put concealer on. Just very lightly, you don't want to pack on the powder. This kind of just sets it and kind of like ensures that the colors aren't going to seep into the foundation and concealer. Now you're going to want to take your favorite foundation. Today I'm mixing these two together to kind of match my skin tone. These are the Maybelline Dewy and Smooth Foundation in 110 and 225. And I'm just gonna dot this all over my face. And then taking my BH Cosmetics Beauty Blender and just patting everything in. After you have all your foundation blended in, you're gonna wanna take a skin tone concealer. My favorite is the Maybelline Fit Me Concealer in Light, and go over all those areas that you put the colors on.